This program was paid for by Water of Life Church. From Water of Life Ministries in Plano, Texas, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is speaking through his servants to the world. He that hath ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying today. Let us join Doyle Davidson and others of Water of Life, sowing the Word of God in spirit and in truth.
Hello, I'm Doyle Davidson, servant apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ, ministering locally to the body of Christ in Dallas and Fort Worth, Texas, sent by God to your house to declare unto you the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 4:15-4 tell us what the gospel is. How that Jesus Christ died for our sins, according to Scripture, he was buried, he rose again the third day, according to the Scripture. Spirit of the Lord's upon me. He's anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, sent me to heal the brokenhearted, preach deliverance to the captives, recovering of sight to the blind, set at liberty them that are bruised. The word is nigh thee, even in your heart and your mouth. There's a word of faith which I preach. If you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, believe in your heart that God and raise him from the dead, you shall be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. It is the power of God unto salvation for everyone that believeth, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek. Therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by his faith. I want to welcome everyone receiving this broadcast live stream on Roku, Apple TV, YouTube, other devices, and shortwave radio. On my left, co-host, Kathie Davidson. Good morning, how are you?
I'm doing well.
You're doing well?
Yes.
Good. You got anything you want to say, or would you rather hear a song?
I'm ready for the mice. It's time to rejoice.
Well, let's have them. You called.
Rejoice for the steps.
May I move on?
Sure.
I'm asking if we could have a song ministered by Terre, the Browns, and maybe Paul Peters, Our God Reigns. Yes. Shock, shock,
yes.
Shock.
Paul is in it.
He is in it.
Yeah.
Thank you.
want you to be prepared to read Psalm 23. I've got to tell a personal story. The Davidsons of my lifetime went through World War II, the Korean War, Vietnam, whatever else. There was never one of them injured or killed. Just a cousin of mine, 9 months older than me, and still alive. He and I are the only two grandsons of Luther Albert Davidson left on the earth. He was in the Korean War, and he was a heavy equipment operator. Most Davidsons could operate any of them. There was a bulldozer left on the side of a hill by an operator and left it and walked off. And a captain told my cousin to go get it. And the bulldozer turned over and cut one of his legs off below the knee. I had not talked to him in years. This morning, I talked to him on the phone. His father was the oldest of Luther Albert's boys and a preacher. And this morning, I talked to Jackie. He was in the hospital. I did not know that, but the Lord had told me 3 or 4 days, call him. And I did. I said, he's a typical Davidson. I'm atypical. I said, you know Jesus lives in your heart? Yes. Amen. We had a very lovely talk. When we got through, he said, thanks for calling. It may have been 50 years since I talked to him. Is Monday Memorial Day?
Tomorrow is Memorial Day, yes.
I saw, as a corpsman, in the Korean War, a lot of them injured permanently. Let's don't talk about that. Let's get on Psalm 23.
Psalm 23, verse 1. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff that comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
We did that psalm, King David.
Amen. That is a psalm of David.
Right. And David came before Jesus Christ, didn't he?
Almost about 1,000 years before Jesus.
1,000 years. Amen. You know, it's difficult at times for me to speak some of this. But I've lived in Psalm 23 for several years. Would you say?
Oh, yeah.
years so back, I kind of came to myself. I said, Kathie, I think I've lived close to the shadow of death the past few years.
Amen.
You remember that?
Yes.
I do. God prepared a table for me in the presence of my enemies. Amen. Without any doubt, I have many enemies. They'd like me to be dead. They hoped I would be.
Amen.
Once, a woman made a phone call and said, have they not cut Doyle Davidson's head off yet? No, I'm talking to you. She hung up. Amen. Thank God. I'm happy to be alive. I'm grateful to have lived these past, going into the, or living in the ninth year, when I started losing my eyesight 9 years ago, over eight, brought on by persecutors, persecuted my soul, and they smote my life down to the earth as a man, long time dead, in the darkness. In the darkness, I've lived, beginning December 08. They increased greatly. In 13, I could not read or see anything since January. I'm 13. I'm not sure of all that brought the dimming of my vision down to where all I could see was my fingers doing this. Amen. But I was brought down in the darkness by the grace and mercies of God. I'm coming out of this darkness. On December 13th of 17, I believe it's right, the Lord said to me in a tongue and interpretation, you want to tell me what he said? Or, you
know, I will look. It's right here.
You got it?
I've got it. December 13th. It says, I am here in person to save you, for you are my brother.
Did you know the Lord is in Plano?
Amen.
Did you know you're that close to him? Did you know he might be in this building?
Oh, he is.
Huh?
He is.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Two or more are gathered in his name. There am I in the midst of you.
Thank you. That's Matthew 18, right?
Amen.
The Lord is here to what? Help me?
Amen.
Do you know what shocked me? I knew this. But what he said, what did he say?
He said, I'm here in person to save you. And then he said, for you are my brother.
Yeah. Hebrews 2, he's not ashamed to call me a brother.
Amen.
And he said that openly. Some of you that are ashamed of me might consider repenting. Maybe they can't. What are you going to do next?
Well, what would you like to do?
Obey God.
I have an exhortation if you'd like.
I want to hear it.
All right. I've received a phone call, well, actually a couple nights ago. I had a young woman contact me, and she was distraught. We were having she messaged me through Facebook, and she was talking about her mother. And she knows who she is, and she won't have any problem with this because I watched God help her. But she said to me in a comment, her mother was dying. And she said, I don't understand. She said, my mother never drank. She never smoked. She never swore. And she always did nice things for people. And why can't we overcome this? And I read her message, and I was, at the time, I was walking the street and praying. And I thought for a minute, I thought, I don't know if I'm ready to answer this back. And the Lord said to me, call her. And I did. And we had a conversation. And it was a wonderful conversation. And at the end of the conversation, before I go on, the end of the conversation, she was able to commit her mother to the Lord.
Amen.
Her mother was born again, had been for years, part of this ministry.
Amen.
But she didn't understand. And one of the things in our conversation I said, and I want everyone to hear this. You can not smoke, and you can not swear, ever. And you cannot drink a drop of liquor and still go to hell.
Amen.
You can give all your money to the poor and still go to hell.
Amen.
You can take care of every old person you know and still go to hell. And she, during our conversation, we got that straightened out. If you will turn with me, somebody describe this, and it's beautiful. If you will go with me to Philippians 3, we're going to see what Paul says about this.
Amen.
And you jump in whenever, and I'll probably light your candle. It says, I'm going to begin. Let's begin in verse 1. It says, finally, my brethren, rejoice in the Lord. To write the same things to you, to me, indeed is not grievous, but for you it is safe. Beware of dogs. Beware of evil workers. Beware of the concision. For we are the circumcision which worship God in the Spirit and rejoice in Christ Jesus and have no confidence in the flesh.
Amen.
No confidence in the flesh. Easy to say, not easy to walk.
Amen.
No confidence in the flesh. Though I might also have confidence in the flesh. For if any man think that he has whereof he might trust in the flesh, I more.
Yeah.
This is top flesh guy, folks. This is Hall of Fame flesh guy.
Amen.
So let's listen. He said, circumcised the eighth day.
Amen.
Of the stock of Israel. Of the tribe of Benjamin.
All right. Amen.
A Hebrew of the Hebrews.
Amen.
Top tier.
Amen.
It says, as touching the law of Pharisee.
Amen.
Touching the law of Pharisee. Concerning zeal, persecuting the church.
Right.
Touching the righteousness which is in the law, blameless.
Amen.
Blameless. Not a swear word crossed his lips.
Amen.
He never looked at his neighbor's wife or the neighbor's daughter. never coveted, never lied, always honored his father and mother, never smoked, never drank. All right? It says, but for the what things were gained to me, those I counted lost for Christ. Lost. He said, yea, doubtless, I count all things but loss for the excellency of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord. Look at this next phrase. For whom I have suffered the loss of all things and do count them but dung. Count them but dung.
Amen.
Counted his being a Hebrew of the Hebrews dung. Do you know what dung is?
Amen.
Go to a farm and ask to see the manure pile. That's dung.
Amen.
That's dung. That's what Paul called being a Hebrew of the Hebrews. That's what Paul called being of the tribe of Benjamin. That's what Paul called being in the law blameless. He counted it all dung. He counted it education dung. He counted his church upbringing dung. He counted his status dung. He counted his money dung. He counted his friends dung. He counted his family dung. He counted his ancestry dung. He counted the money he made dung. He counted the car he drives dung. Why? Why? That I may win Christ and be found in him, not having my own righteousness, which is of the law. Which is of the law. You got guts to realize that not smoking, not drinking, not swearing, not dancing, not doing those things will not get you Jesus.
Amen.
It will not get you Jesus, and you can go to hell not doing those things.
Amen.
Not doing those things. What do you need? It says, being found in him, not having my own righteousness, which is of the law, but that which is through the faith of Christ, the righteousness which is of God by faith. By faith. By faith. And you say, well, if you can't trust in your education, and you can't trust in your religious upbringing, and you can't trust in your status, and you can't trust in your family, what do you trust in?
Amen.
What this man next to me taught me the day I came here, the first day. Turn with me to Mark 1.
Amen.
I will show you what you trust in. I will show you that your education cannot get you to heaven. Your behavior cannot get you to heaven.
Amen.
All right? It says, Mark 1, 14. Now, after John was put in prison, Jesus came into Galilee preaching the gospel.
Amen.
Of the kingdom of God, saying, the time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent you. Repent you. You know what repent you means? Change the way you think. Change the way you believe. Change what you trust in. Change what you trust in. You trust in your head, you're going to have to change it. You trust in your education, you're going to have to change it. You trust in your family, you're going to have to change it. You're going to have to change. Change the way you're thinking. And what do you think? It says, repent you and believe the gospel. Trust in the gospel. Trust in the gospel. The righteousness which is by faith. What is righteousness? Doing the right thing. Doing the Father's right thing. Doing Jesus' right thing. That's righteousness. What Jesus did was righteous. What we do is cow manure. You put your trust in the gospel. Now, what is the gospel? 1 Corinthians 15.
Amen.
This is the gospel. This is what will get you to heaven. This is what will keep you out of hell. This is what will guide you. This is where your salvation comes from, where your money will come from, where your healing comes from, where your family getting fixed comes from. It comes from the gospel. It comes from the gospel. It says, moreover, brethren, 1 Corinthians 15:1, I declare unto you the gospel, which I preached unto you, which also you have received, and wherein you stand. This is from the man that counted everything dung so he could win Jesus. You know what you got when you got Jesus? You got power. You got power.
Thank you.
You got the power to change your situations.
Hallelujah.
That's what you get when you get Jesus. You have the power to change your situation. It says, by which also we are saved. That's changing your situation. By which you are saved, born again, and anything else you need. If you need a job, saved is getting a job. If you need healed, healed is getting saved. Saved, sozo, anything you need. It says, by which also you are saved, if you keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless you have believed in vain. For I declared unto you, first of all, which I also received. This is the man that counted everything dung, and this is what he gained. It says, verse 3, how that Christ died for our sins, according to the scriptures, and that he was buried. And that he rose again the third day according to the scriptures. That is the gospel. That is what you trust in. That is what you put your faith in. That is what you look at. That is what you keep your eye on. That is what you walk in. That is what you trust in instead of your education and your money and your upbringing and all that other stuff. It is the gospel that brings the power of God that changes your situation. It's the gospel that Jesus died for you.
Amen.
I want to just share a quick thing here about that dying for you. Do you know that God put Jesus on the cross? And he put Jesus on the cross for you.
Amen.
And you know what the wonderful thing about what God put Jesus on the cross happened? God made sure when his only son was hanging on the cross for us, as a man, he made sure that every single sin that you and I had ever done was put on Jesus's body. Every single sin. Every single sin. And he made sure that every single sin was on him before Jesus died. He didn't miss any. He didn't overlook any. Every single thing you've done went on that body, and God made sure of it. He made sure of it. Yes, that one went on there. Had to. That's what Isaiah 53 says. He took the iniquity of us all and laid it on Jesus. You know why he did that? Because when Jesus died and all that sin was on Jesus, and if God Father put it there, when Jesus died, they put a spear in his side and his blood came out.
Yes.
And you know what that blood was? That blood satisfied the Father for every single sin that went on that body. That blood that came out of that man had every single sin on it that you could have ever done. And he poured it out. And now you and I can stand before the Father with that blood. And God looks right at us. Why can he look right at us? Because that blood justified you. That blood took your sin on itself, and you can stand before the Father in that blood without any sin. None. Don't you think that's good news? Don't you think that's better than your college education? Don't you think that's God's better than that car you drive or that career you wanted. Don't you think that's better? You know what that blood will do? It'll get you what you need to have your situation changed. You can stand right in front of Jehovah and he will look right at you and cause you have no sin. You see why Paul laid it all down? Do you see that's what gets you into heaven? That's what gets you into heaven. Not your behavior, not your attitude. The blood of Jesus gets you into heaven. Now it's yours.
My time?
Yeah.
How much time do I have left?
You have 20 minutes left.
Would you find, I think it's in the book of Luke, where Jesus preached about Abraham and the rich man in hell?
Oh, yes.
Well, while you're finding it, I got to tell a story, a testimony. You see, I was born as a Davidson and a Miller. Both of them had preachers. Both of them. One, disciples of Christ. Another, John Wesley, Methodist Holiness. But in it, they had the same messages. In 1958, 26 years of age, I'd been in the Navy Hospital Corps for 4 years. I'd finished 72 hours of pre-veterinary medicine classes, and I was about to enter School of Veterinary Medicine, University of Missouri, class of 62. I like nice cars and fast cars. And I wasn't afraid to drive them fast. I never had a wreck until that tore everything up. No, till I started serving the Lord. And I was living in Plano. It didn't tear everything up, but it got close. But back to 1958, I was rotating the tires on a hardtop 1954 Mercury at a green top, and the body was yellow. If you don't know what a hard top Mercury is, the windows, the doors didn't have the window post on them. There was nothing there. And that thing was hot. I had a mechanic that took care of Dad's trucks and cars. Every time he'd see me, get that car in here, I want to see if it's running right. And he wouldn't charge me a penny. He just did it because of Dad and the Lord. And that car I enjoyed. It would move. And I was rotating the tires on it. And I had every one done, all three of them done. The fourth one, the right front, I'd put the wheel back. I had to put the hubcap on. And something hit me. Something fell on me. It was a cloud, a presence. It was the Lord. And guess what? I started praying. I'd always pray if I wasn't heard. My man, I did a lot of praying in my life. A lot of talking to Jesus. Oh my goodness. You know what we're going to have to do?
Oh, yeah.
Following this, the quartet, just a little talk with Jesus. All right?
Yep.
All right. But the first words that came out of my mouth, I went to my knees. I was sitting in a squatting position, and my prayer, oh God, don't send me to hell. Oh God, don't send me to hell. I thought I was dying. Moses said to be in the presence of God was what?
Exceedingly fearful and quaking.
That's what he said, right?
Exceeding fear and quake.
Amen. And you know, the flesh can't get in the presence of God.
Amen.
Oh, it can, but it gets uncomfortable. Real uncomfortable. It can't get in the presence of the gospel. It gets real uncomfortable. But a person that's born again, cleansed by the blood, justified, sanctified, made righteous, redeemed, I've kind of got them out of order, forgiven all sins, it doesn't bother them being in the presence of God. Amen. Kathie, would you read this account about hell?
I sure will.
I didn't want to talk about hell.
Amen.
But today we are.
Luke 16, verse 19. There was a certain rich man which was clothed in purple and fine linen and fared sumptuously every day. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus which was laid at his gate full of sores and desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores. It came to pass that the beggar died and was carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom. The rich man also died and was buried. It says, and in hell he lifted up his eyes, being in torments, and seeing Abraham afar off and Lazarus in his bosom. And he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me and send Lazarus that he may dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am tormented in this flame. But Abraham said, Son, remember thou that thou in thy lifetime receiveth thou good things, and likewise Lazarus evil things, but now he is comforted, and thou art tormented. Besides all this, between us and you there is a great gulf fixed, so that they which would pass from thence to you cannot, neither can they pass to us which would come from thence. Then he said, I pray thee, therefore, Father, that thou would send him to my father's house, for I have five brethren, that he may testify unto them, lest they also come into this place of torment. And Abraham saith unto him, they have Moses and the prophets, let them hear them. And he said, nay, Father Abraham, but if one went unto them from the dead, they will repent.
Amen.
And he said unto them, if they hear not Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded, though one rose from the dead.
Who preached that?
Jesus did. The letters are read.
Really? You started this off with Mark 1.
Amen.
When I started my ministry, preaching, I started in Mark 1.
Amen.
But then, the day came where I had to preach from the book of Luke. And what chapter is that?
That is chapter 16.
Yeah. And Jesus preached it.
Yes, he did.
The man of love. The warm, fuzzy preacher. Oh, yes. Jesus will preach the cold prickly too. Don't kid yourself. Jesus will not skip anything in the Bible. I had a good friend. I loved him dearly. I said, you really must love the Psalms. Dare you read them. Preach them. You must love the Psalms. He said, Doyle,
10 minutes.
You must know which one to read. Did you know, I'm glad I didn't listen to him. Amen. When I started reading the Psalms, I started Psalm 1. And I finished with 150. Look, folks. I believe it's the 15th chapter of the book of Romans. Paul talks about coming, preaching the fullness of the blessing of the gospel of Christ.
Amen.
Is that where that's at?
Yes.
15 Romans. Fullness comes in the fullness.
Verse 29.
You know what he said in Romans 1? I believe it's Romans 1. When I come, as much as in me is, I will preach the gospel.
Thank God.
Amen.
Doesn't that say that?
Yes, it does. 15.
Huh?
15. It says, so as much as in me is, I am ready to preach the gospel to you that are at Rome also.
Amen. Did you know? God started me out with Romans, chapter 1. He ended me up in the 16th chapter. And that one got me. About the heart of the simple. Hearts of the simple. Did I say that?
I believe so.
Yeah, with fair speeches. They deceive the hearts of the simple. Does that say that?
It does. Verse 18. For they that are such serve not our Lord Jesus Christ, but their own belly. And by good words and fair speeches deceive the hearts of the simple.
Did you know what? I had to stop and think. Am I a simple person? Yeah. I said, you better be. You better be. You better have a heart of the simple and not listen to fair speeches.
Amen.
How much time have I got?
You had about 7 minutes left.
Good. I pray that God will deliver you out of those houses. That was what? Good words?
Right. And fair speeches.
And fair speeches deceive your hearts and send you on the road of destruction. I'm telling some preachers, you need to have a little talk with Jesus. You need to have a little talk with Jesus right now. I'd like to water my quartet do one of my favorite songs. Years ago, I learned it, heard this. Always loved it and always will. Let's hear it.
I once was lost in sin, but Jesus took me in. And then a little light from heaven filled my soul. It made my heart in love and wrote my name above. And just a little talk with Jesus made me Jesus,
let us
tell him all about our trouble.
He will
hear our faintest cry.
He will
answer by and by.
You
feel a little prayer will turn him,
and you
know a little fire is burning.
You will
find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. I may have doubts and fears. My eyes be filled with tears, but Jesus is a friend who watches day and night. I go to him in prayer, he knows my every care, and just a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
Now let us
have a little talk with Jesus.
Let us
tell him all about our trouble.
He will
hear our faintest cry.
He will
answer by and by.
You
feel a little prayer will turn it,
and you
know a little fire is burning.
You will
find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus.
Let us
tell him all trouble.
He will
hear our faintest cry.
He will
answer by and by.
You
feel a little prayer will turn it,
but you
know a little fire is burning.
You will
find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus.
Let us
tell him all about our trouble.
He will
hear our faintest cry.
He will
answer by and by.
You
feel a little prayer will turn it,
and you
know a little fire is burning.
You will
find a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
How much time?
About 3 minutes.
Good. As a young boy, I loved quartets. I loved to hear them sing. And I have James. I always loved that song. Years ago, I heard it as a teenager. I heard it on the radio. KWTO, Springfield, Missouri. If you want to know what KWTO stands for, keep watching the Ozarks. They had some good music on there. Red Foley was on there. Red Foley, I believe, is Pat Boone's wife, Shirley's father. Had all kinds. I loved to hear them sing. I never forgot to talk to Jesus. I talked to him. I wondered why he didn't answer. One day he did.
One minute.
I want your life. I want your life. And I'm going to take it. You know, there are two choices, heaven or hell. You're going one or the other. You're either going to be with Jesus or you're going to be with the devil. Thank God.
30 seconds.
Inhale. I'm giving you a chance to be saved. All you have to do is speak the name of Jesus after me and you'll be saved. Jesus. Jesus.
Yeah.
You know, Jeremiah chapter 5, or is it 4? 23. Pointed weeks, it's 5, isn't it?
Right. Well, it's 4, I think.
Oh, it's 4.
Oh, it is chapter 5? Okay.
Okay. Pointed weeks of the harvest.
Thank God.
You know, we're in that time. You know, we're blessed to preach the gospel.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Preach the gospel and preach the full counsel of God.
Amen.
And not be afraid.
Amen.
That we'll offend somebody's soul.
And they'll say, you're not talking in love.
Do what?
And they'll say, you're not talking in love.
Right.
What is it Paul said? I shun not to preach the full counsel
right.
of God.
The Apostle Paul said that
right.
in Acts 20.
Amen.
When he called the elders of the church together and preached to them.
Amen.
That's Acts 20. Thank God.
Amen.
My friends, you want to receive Jesus. Don't reject him. And don't be ashamed to talk about him.
Amen.
And don't be afraid to talk to him.
Hallelujah.
Because he'll listen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
And remember this. When you're talking on this earth, you may say something that he hears. Ha. Every word.
Yes.
I remember back when I was had some silly, soulish thoughts about I wasn't sure Jesus was related or related proper or wanted me with him. Man, did a tongue interpretation come? Did it?
That's the one where he said, you are my brother?
Yeah.
Right.
He blew in like a big tornado. And what did he say? I am here.
I am here to save you.
Yeah.
Or I am your brother. I'm here in person to save you.
Yeah, in person. Did you know Jesus is in person in Plano
Amen.
Right now?
Amen.
Did you know he's in person in Rome?
Amen.
Right now?
Amen.
Did you know he's in person in Sarkozy right now? Where in the world is that? Well, as best I can tell, that town where I was born, there's not another one on earth with that name. Is that?
As far as I've studied there, yes, there's no other Sarkozy anywhere.
Amen. So, I think it's probably appropriate if I say, I'm Doyle of Sarkozy. Amen. But you know what? I've got to hear a song. By the My Girls. Can you tell me what it is?
No, I've got several running around in my heart.
Oh, how about out of Psalm 23?
Amen.
Yes.
Huh?
Amen.
Yeah, let's have it.
Hallelujah.
Show the goodness and mercy.
Oh,
to request two songs. And I'm going to tell something I just now learned that I should tell. So I would like to have Terre and the Browns with Looking for a City. Following that, I would like to hear a song that my mother played on the piano, sung for years. And that song is the Old Rugged Cross. And the person singing it could do it live if they want to. But back to my mother. My mother, as a young woman, a young Baptist woman, told God one day, "You give me a son, I'll give him back to you." I don't know when that communication took place. My sister, Dorothy, who's in heaven, born in 29. Mother and Dad were married in 27. I was born in 32. And guess what? There's quite a bit written about that son that Alvin said, "You give me, I'll give him back to you." And that would be me. And she could do the Old Rugged Cross, but she could do In the Garden. Did we have that song ready? The Old Rugged Cross?
She's ready to do it live. Do you want the other one first?
Do what?
I said she is ready to do it. Well, she's going to get ready to do it live. But you wanted another song first? Looking for a City.
Looking for a City. Thank you. Well, you think I don't need help? Thank you.
Here among the shadows, living in a lonely land,
with strangers,
we're a band of pilgrims on the move,
with dangers
burdened down with sorrows,
and we're
shunned on every hand,
but we are
looking for a city built above.
Oh yes, we're
looking here and there,
looking for a city
yonder
way. In the blessed Savior's love
and mercy,
though we may be strangers
living
in this world of care,
we're always
looking for a city built above.
Oh yes, we're
looking for a city.
We will
never say goodbye.
Say goodbye.
it says in Psalm 143, persecuted my soul and brought me to the ground. As a man, long time dead, and in the great darkness. And believe me, I've suffered a bunch from their persecutions. But I'm coming out every day of what they did to my soul. Now, here should be Terre Brown.
Cling to the old rugged cross.
Now we've got Paul Peters coming up, right?
Amen.
That's right.
I'd rather have Jesus. Is that it?
That's right.
Thank God. After that, I'd like to have Kathie my show of the presence.
Amen.
In the midst of his children,
And the Lord said, you're not going to do this any longer. You're going to follow me. 1975 in the wilderness, I went before the Lord one day. And I started speaking, praying, a prayer that I believe King David prayed. And that was, the word that thou hast spoken concerning thy servant and his household. Do as thou hast said, and establish it forever. I prayed that, pretty close to that, for many, many times, having no idea where I was going. And the song, Who Am I, sure fits this person. And Terre Brown can do it in song as well as anyone. Terre?
Mm-hmm. so far from glory, came to dwell among the lowly, such as I, to suffer shame and such disgrace. This question, who am I? Who am I that the King would bleed and die for? Who am I that He would pray, not my will, Thine Lord? The answer I cross he'd go, for who am I? When I'm reminded of his words, I'll leave thee never. If you'll be true, I'll give to you life forever. Have done to deserve God's only Son, to fight my battles until they're won, for who am I? Who am I that the King would bleed and die for? My will, Thine Lord. The answer I may never know, why He ever loved me so, that to an old rugged cross He'd go, for who am I? That to an old rugged cross He'd go, for who am I?
Thank you. Kathie?
Yes, sir.
You got anything?
No.
You don't?
No, I don't.
Well, I just want to give God some praise and glory.
Amen.
You know, I was raised in a house with a mother, a dad, older sister, one just younger, and then Glenda. They could all sing. And mother could play that piano and sing. She'd do it for hours. Someone said she sung her way into heaven.
Amen.
I don't doubt it. What a blessing that God has put upon me to compass me with great voices, beautiful songs, and well prepared.
Amen.
Tracks, more than one, made by David Brown. Just amazing. You know, I thought I'd let everybody go to lunch, but they're going to have to go on the holy highway.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank God. Mercy. Grace. Mercy. Grace. Mercy. Grace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and the Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you. See you at 6.
We invite you to visit Water of Life Church at 1621 18th Street in Plano, Texas. Or for further information, call area code 972-578-8082. That's 972-578-8082. Or write Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. That's Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. This program was paid for by Water of Life Church.